video includes remarks from five NIH Institute and Center directors sharing their visions for the Bridge to Artificial Intelligence program.
Hi, I'm Patty Brennan, Director of the National Library of Medicine. I'm delighted to be here today to welcome you to the Bridge to AI program. Bridge to AI is an exciting new initiative that brings all of the NIH together to think about how we can harness the power of artificial intelligence, or AI, to accelerate biological discoveries and improve health for all. Now, the Bridge to AI program takes a very interesting and unique approach. Rather than generating data sets under problem-inspired or hypothesis-driven research, we are proposing that by generating AI-ready data sets, we will accelerate our ability to be able to use AI techniques for discovery. This requires that we identify a problem domain and bring together a wide group of perspectives on that problem domain so that we're able to generate data that is relevant in describing a specific phenomenon or problem from a number of different vantage points. Data that is collected, properly curated, and made available in a systematic and secure way to those who want to bring the tools and techniques of AI, either developed within healthcare or brought from other disciplines, will certainly be of great value to the country. In addition, this approach will allow us to understand a wide variety of problems that we currently have trouble getting a broad enough picture on. For example, during the coronavirus pandemic, we needed to understand individuals, family and household behavior, and community activities. Were we to specifically generate an AI-ready data set that described an individual, their physiology, their risk propensity, their exposures, their household living, the way they eat, work, sleep, and play, and the community around them, the density of the community, the level of infectivity in that environment, or even the possibility of following public health recommendations, we would be able to better predict where hotspots for the COVID pandemic were likely to occur, or maybe better understand how to bring together the right set of resources to improve an individual's ability to recover from the COVID-19 disease. This project and all of you here together are here because we believe it's essential to create teams of individuals that understand physiology, psychology, public health, environmental health, mathematics, computer science, and analytics. We need to bring important curation techniques that the Library of Medicine can help support. We need to bring important conceptual skills from a variety of perspectives to come together to build the bridge to AI, bringing data to the challenges of health.
Well, I'm Michael Chang, and I'm director of the National AI Institute, and I will describe one big win that I hope can come out of Bridge to AI that's based on my experience as a practicing ophthalmologist, but it's really much broader than just eye care. So the premise is that most existing clinical AI systems are really used to diagnose fairly narrow problems. For example, does this retinal image have diabetic retinopathy that needs treatment? Or does this skin lesion show malignant melanoma? So as a general rule, the narrower the problem definition is, the easier it is to train an AI to answer it. And the problem, of course, is that clinicians do not just look at an image to answer one question. They'll look at an image or a series of many images to diagnose multiple diseases. And they'll typically combine image data with clinical data, demographic data, and even genetic data. And so far, we really haven't seen many AI systems that can approach this ability to answer more complex questions or integrate multiple data types. And along those lines, one big challenge is that AI systems frequently work only for the specific populations and imaging devices that they were initially trained on. Whereas the real world problem is that we need AIs that work broadly across devices and populations. So in the spirit of addressing these questions, one really big win for Bridge to AI would be to develop data sets that allow researchers to expand from one disease to multiple, and to really incorporate clinical data from electronic health records and also genetic data into those AI diagnostic models, and to really get those recommendations back into EHRs, and of course, to work broadly across devices and populations. And a related problem is to take data from an area, from one area, like a retinal scan or a brain scan, to uncover pathologies in other parts of the body, or identify biomarkers for those findings elsewhere in the body. So I really hope that we can use Bridge2AI to move into knowledge discovery. Now, these are really ambitious goals, and yeah, I think it's probably more of a huge win than a big win. But the Bridge2AI data generation teams, I think, will get us a lot closer. And so I will look forward to seeing what's next.
Hello, I'm Eric Green, Director of the National Human Genome Research Institute. I'm extremely excited about Bridge2AI, and I hope that you will be as well. You know, at the scale and complexity of data that biomedical science currently generates, without artificial intelligence working hand in hand with human intelligence, we will miss some opportunities to gain new biological insights and to design new treatment strategies. The Bridge2AI program is thus incredibly important and extremely timely. Over the last few decades, genomics has been changing how we conduct biomedical research, how we study and in some cases manage human disease, and how we view the diversity in our society and across the human species. Building upon the success of the Human Genome Project, a massive reduction in the cost of sequencing a human genome, and the dawn of the CRISPR gene editing era, genomics is now leading us to an even more audacious future, a future that will define our collective lives for decades to come. But there's still areas where there are more questions than there are answers in genomics. For example, understanding the roles and relationships of genes and regulatory elements and pathways and networks, and then how those pathways and networks impact human disease. And given the nearly boundless experimental space and complexity needed for this, we really require artificial intelligence solutions for tackling these kinds of genomics-related challenges. Another area where genomics and artificial intelligence can work together is in advancing genomic medicine, possibly by creating new models of medicine where physicians use clinical decision support tools based on artificial intelligence to choose the best treatment for a patient guided by the genomic variants that each of us has. My fellow Bridge2AI co-chairs and I are very happy that you'll be joining us to help solve these and other biomedical research challenges. We hope that you will come together as teams and bring a wealth of diverse backgrounds and skills and experiences to apply Bridge2AI funding announcement and use it in a fashion that will build wonderful bridges between the worlds of artificial intelligence and biomedical research. Thank you.
I'm Helene Langevin, Director of the National Center for Complementary and Integrative Health, or NCCIH. We are very excited about the opportunity offered by Bridge2AI to tackle grand challenges that so far have been beyond the reach of biomedical science. One such grand challenge is the understanding of salutogenesis, or the process by which an individual can move from a less healthy to a healthier state. Over the past century, biomedical research has mostly focused on understanding and treating disease, while our understanding of health has lagged behind. One of the reasons for this is that the process of restoring health is complex and involves the whole person. And so far, we have lacked the tools and methods to address this challenging question. We know that many chronic conditions, such as diabetes, cardiovascular disease, degenerative joint disease, and depression often co-occur in the same individual. And these conditions are often managed with drugs that can have side effects and can interfere with one another. On the other hand, the same lifestyle interventions, improving one's diet, getting more exercise, and managing stress, can together restore healthier function in multiple organs and systems. What we don't know is whether restoration of health or salutogenesis is simply pathogenesis in reverse, or whether it requires some specific salutogenic or healing pathways to be engaged in order to bring the individual back towards health. And what interventions can best support the salutogenesis process? Answering these complex questions requires the generation and analysis of large, multi-dimensional biomedical and behavioral data sets, and artificial intelligence is tailor-made for this task. The Bridge2AI program will support the building of diverse, multidisciplinary teams combining clinicians, engineers, data scientists, and ethicists, and empower these teams to make a transformative leap in the science of health.
Hi, my name is Bruce Tromberg, and I'm the director of the National Institute for Biomedical Imaging and Bioengineering. NIBIB is proud to be one of the co-sponsors of the exciting new Common Fund initiative, Bridge2AI. As the director of the Engineering Institute at NIH, I'm pleased to say that our community plays a special role in this initiative. One of the unifying characteristics of biomedical engineers is our commitment to the idea that biological processes can be represented symbolically by mathematical equations that have explainable free parameters. With enough measurements and the right equations, we believe it's possible to understand and predict the behavior of any complex biologic system. Of course, in reality, we never seem to have enough observations, and though we may have equations that work under perfect conditions, biologic processes almost always distort the ideal physics. Fortunately, that's where AI can come in and drive major advances. For example, with the right observations and computational approaches, we anticipate AI will be able to help us deduce new laws that describe the emergent properties of complex biologic systems. It's a daunting task, but there's never been a better time to take this on. Imagine quantitative computational representations or digital twins of a wide range of biologic processes, from organs to entire humans. This would have enormous impact in both basic science and the practice of medicine. In addition to helping us understand emergent properties, Bridge2AI could be a game changer for diagnostic and therapeutic technologies that rely on the precise tracking and delivery of energy into or emanating from the body. The many ways tissue can distort our idealized equations for energy transport are well understood. However, turning those distortions into discoveries that reveal the unique fingerprints of life processes is one of our biggest challenges. In practical terms, these advances will inspire more powerful methods and technologies for disease detection, diagnosis, therapy, and even prevention. Thank you for taking time to listen to some of the unique bioengineering opportunities in Bridge2AI. Speaking on behalf of all my colleagues at NIBIB and across NIH, good luck. We look forward to seeing your applications.